This is Innovledia.
Hello and welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to snap and align objects and their components in Maya. Alright? Now that we know how to manipulate objects and their components in the 3D space, here we'll take a look at how to manipulate them precisely without spending a lot of time in manual adjustments. So basically, what is snapping? In simple terms, snapping is the process of changing the location of an object from one place to another instantly at the click of a button. So it is more like jumping from one place to another instead of gradual movement. Now, how do we snap objects in Maya? Well, there are many ways to do that. Maya has many types of snapping methods, out of which the two most frequently used are the grid snap and the point snap. Practically, you will hardly ever need to go with any other method than these two. To use the grid snap method, you have to click on this icon on the status line to activate it, and then activate the move tool. Using this, you can move objects exactly on the grid lines in any direction. It will not move in fraction, but in whole number units, like 1, 2, 3, and so on. One thing that you should note here is that the object is positioned on the grid using its pivot. Like, if its pivot is located within its center, the object will always snap with its center aligned to the grid. So, if I move the pivot of the object from its center to its corner by pressing and holding down the D key, and then if I snap the object on the grid, you will notice that the object now moves differently than before. Now it moves with its border aligned to the grid lines as we snap it along the grid. An object is snapped using its pivot. So how an object will snap depends on the location of its pivot. And hence, the object's movement will always be relative to where its pivot is located. Alright? Now, coming to the point snap, we have to click on this icon on the status line to activate it. And then, if I select an object and start moving it, it will jump from one location to another based on where the vertices or points are located on the other object. Alright? So, this is how we can snap objects to a particular location using the grid snap and the point snap methods. Now, we'll take a look at how to snap the components of an object. To snap the components of an object, first we have to switch to a particular component mode, such as the vertex mode, and then activate the grid snap option. Using the move tool, you can snap the vertices the same way you can do with the objects. This is mostly useful when we want to resize the object to a particular dimension based on the grid values, or we want to align it properly with other objects within the scene. Alright? Now, if we activate the point snap option, we would be able to snap the vertices to the nearest points or other vertices. This is useful when you want to align the vertices on top of each other so that we can merge them together to form a single vertex. Alright? Lastly, both of these grid snap and point snap can be activated using the X key and V key respectively on your keyboard when needed. The X key will activate the grid snap option, while the V key will activate the point snap option. But you need to press and hold it down like always, otherwise it will return to the normal mode instead of the snapping mode, alright? Now, let me show you an example of how you can align an object using these snapping methods, okay? So I have to put these wheels on the axle of the skateboard. First, let me switch to the orthographic view so that I can look at it from the side. And then, select the wheel and activate the grid snap option using the X key on your keyboard. And then, start moving the wheel until it snaps to the grid intersection where the axle is lying. The other wheel can be aligned in the same way. In this way, the center of the wheels will always be aligned to the center of the axle, without requiring us to manually adjust their position. These snapping functions will be useful throughout the entire course as we move along from modeling to animation. Okay? So this is how we can snap and align objects and their components in Maya. Alright? See you in the next video.